Hello, it is I, Dr. Brian Lorgon 111. Last time, we solved the difficult orange level, and now we have the difficult Ouroboros. Okay, so this could be interesting. Will there be more recursion? I expect so, because I only see 8 of these things. Well, there's something on the outside. Can't really tell. Long distance. That requires an orange, and I am pushing. I'm making a left input, and it pushed this, implying that I had a friend over on the other side, a long distance away. Yeah, I have friends who are, I'm making inputs like I'm going up and then left, up, right, down, right, up, right. There's some of my friends. Hello, friend. Friend, let's see. Okay, so you were doing that. Great. How do I reason about what to do next over here? I guess you might be able to shear this off of me, or actually I can shear it off of myself like this. And then if I come over here, I can pull these out. And then you could go in here and go another layer deeper. So this was long distance. And it just brings me back to long distance because they're recursive, but now this is the orange and so I've solved it. Great. And then I can back out and that one's lit up. Okay, I get it. I get it. Puzzle box. I'm puzzled about this box. That brings us back to puzzle box. I need to get the grape out. And it would be helpful if I were inside, I think. Oh. No. It would be helpful if I were inside, which means I should do this and then recurse into it. And now I'm inside. And now I would like the grape to go outside. And so I want to be here, but have the grape be outside. So if I do this... No, the grape is still inside. Like, how would I get the grape outside? Hold on. I think I want to... Okay, here's an idea. What if I go in n times? 2 is probably enough. If I then try to back it, I'm still not the... I have to get the grape jelly out. But I do want to see what happens. So if I do this and I press back, I'm back over here and it also moved this back to where it was. Okay, so it's not the case. When you go forward, you kind of preserve the state. When you go back, you discard all the state you've done on this frame of the stack. Okay. Is there... If I am inside, is there some type of leverage I can do taking advantage of the grape jelly in order to... something something? It's not clear to me that there is. Is there any way that I can provide a shearing force or do something to try to break apart this box? Puzzle box. I don't think I see a way. Oh, what if I do this? Now I'm in here. And now I can start shearing apart the box. Got it. So the box is still stuck together over there, and so if I do a similar move over here... Oh, except for I'm currently inside. First, I have to get outside. I am outside the box. Then I have to get into this hole. I am in the hole. Then I need to shear these bits apart, and now I can finally pull the whole thing apart. And having done so, then I should be able to get some leverage on grape jelly. Ooh. Yeah. Yeah, here we go. Kind of. I could shear it off over here. And now it's almost floating somewhere useful. It is floating somewhere useful because now I can just push it out. I did it. I did the thing. Solved. Okay. Let's back. And there we go. Okay, that was cool. This one's entitled Crowd. Everybody is eyeballs. And if I try to enter, it's going to tell me I can't. Too many jellies are attempting to enter a power level. Okay. So I have to deal with the crowd. I get it. It's two there. So a way for me to get the jellies away would be with a rightward move after both of them have right spaces. And so if I do this, I should be able to move forward. What is my goal? It's hard to see, but under this grape jelly, there is an orange hole right there. So I think I just have to get an orange there, and that seems like it's not going to be hard. Because I feel like I can just treat this as a sliding puzzle and move jelly around until it all works out. Yeah, this feels like this is going to totally work. Here we go. This should solve it. Great! Great is what I am. Okay, so that one is solved. Parody crowd. Oh my gosh, the yellow glows so hot. What am I doing here? I need to get the coconut out. I understand. So I need, so if I move to the right and then back to the left, now coconut is the only one sitting on top. Oh, but he can't enter because there's also a strawberry in the way. I understand. So I need to somehow break apart the structure I'm a part of over here such that nobody's on a level or on the or on the green arrow. And I'm not sure how I would do that because, yeah, parody indeed. Feels like I'm just kind of pushing the lump in the carpet around. Is there a way that I can change my structure in here? None of these colors interact with one another, so I'm just pushing around the spaces, so no. So what am I not thinking of? One of us can go join the coconut. If I can get exactly one entering a level, is that possible? Yes. For example, here. Grape is going to enter coconut. No, he enters the level, but that's fine. That's fine and dandy. Because now Grape's parody is still no good, but I can fix it. There we go. And then if I go right and left, now Coconut is the only one standing on a thing, which means Coconut can join us out here for the party and then go win the level. Great. Cool. I like these puzzles. They're my jam. They're my jam. They're my jelly, you might say. It's a very sticky party. What can I say? All the best parties. Okay. Do I have a friend that I can't see? And if I did, where would they be? deep stack part one. Oh no, I could push that way. Okay, deep stack part one. It's telling me that there's going to be a part two. So I'm going to go deep into the sticky jelly party. And this will bring me to deep stack part two, where I will still fail to solve the level, but now be in deep stack part one. What did I accomplish there? Felt like nothing. But now I've seen that it just appears to be two parts. So let's inspect parts one and two again. I would need to solve the level. So I need to get my strawberry over there. But I need to solve this level to get over there. Or can I push? I could have pushed this downwards. No, I can only push it left and right because the little wings are always trapped in that thing. So that's just like a little airlock. So I don't see what else I could have done. I can't solve this because I don't have a grape to put on the grape target. Presumably, if I were to solve Deep Stack 2, it would give me a grape. Suppose I back out. It does, yeah, we discussed this before. Leave me in the state I was in. Is there a different state that would have helped me? If I were in the south edge over here, it wouldn't. Oh! This could move to the left from this state. If I were not inside of it. But there's nothing that could push it to the left. So I don't think that's meaningful. And if I back out again into this one. Oh, this is a new state of Deep Stack Part 1, I think. So if I go in, hold on, if I go in from here. Oh no, this is not an entrance, this is just where I would enter the level. Can I cycle around again? I can. Okay, I did not appreciate this before. So I can cycle all the way around the level. And I could choose not to enter Deep Stack Part 2 and instead just cycle the level again. Is that interesting or noteworthy? I feel like I'm making minor, I won't even call them discoveries, observations. But none of those observations matter or are helpful. I can't go down here. I can't go down here. I can't go down here. Over here, I can't pull this thing to the left, can't move it to the left here, and whether or not I move this back doesn't seem to really affect anything of value for me. And backing out always just leaves me at one of these two spots. I don't have an idea on that one right now, and so I'm gonna hope that some idea from one of these other puzzles enters my brain and allows me to solve that. So we have some easy Tetris puzzles. Possibly the same one over and over again. And I solve them to do activations. And those activations are going to give me the other colors I need to achieve my targets. Let's solve this one first. Red O to J. If I were to do this, I could still lift all of this up. And if I push it against the left wall, I would regret it. So let's not do that. And instead, if I do this, there's no way to get the bottom piece back out, is there? Well, other than kind of undoing what I've done. I could make a T-shape for temporary and then turn it into this kind of L. These are all things that I can do. From here, I could turn it this way, and that would enable me to shear this to the right, which I feel like is getting a little bit closer to the solution. But where do I eventually want to go? Well, I could do this. That feels like it's even closer. And I see that I could make a T this way, which I could then push down like this and this. And finally push that way. Probably not the optimal way to get there, but we got there. It lights up everything at once. I am located in the middle. If I were to try to exit this way, I would undo an important thing. So let's not do that. Coconut needs to go at the bottom left, grape needs to go at the middle right, and then I need to end up over there too. To get coconut to the bottom left, it looks to me like I might be able to have enough room to maneuver the two of them around one another over here. Do I think that's actually true? I think it might be true. So I'm going to try it. I'm having second thoughts. Suppose instead I push this down one more, then push this over. Now I have room to get around this and push it over. And that did most of what I need to do, but not all of it. I can get the coconut to its square now, but now I can't get to the grape jelly again. So could I have gone a different way? Back when I was here, suppose the grape jelly had gone north. Can I recurse into the puzzle? Yes. And if I did that after having made a change, for example, this change, is that what I want to do? So suppose I get the coconut here, then recurse. I do have to solve this again. All right, well, you just watched me do this a moment ago, so I'll do it on my own. So having resolved this, it does keep things in the same position, but I came back out here. I did not restart over here, which is what I was hoping. It was going to reposition me like that. So that didn't happen. So if I back out, oh, then it just takes me all the way back out. Okay. So what do I think I'm doing here? What indeed? So I could have solved the puzzle from any position. So I could reset and then, for example, start from here. This will just go ahead and activate. And now I'm starting from the left. Is this better? Somehow? I would not expect it to be so, but it's possible. So, suppose we drop off the coconut here for a moment. That feels really bad, but I'm going to do it anyway. Then stash a grape jelly here. Yeah, I'm never getting the coconut back to where it needs to go, as far as I can tell. Okay, so I'm going to reset again. And suppose I start from here. Favorite child. Yeah, one of these three is the quote-unquote favorite child. One of these three is going to be the good solution, I think. Well, second-guessing myself again. Like, now the blue is stuck against the wall. Everything's stuck, right? Yeah, I don't like this. If I reset again, was there something I didn't see from starting up here? Like, this is the main place where I have space to kind of do some work and then reverse it. Oh, can I go this way? How did that break? It was because I stuck to the strawberry. Right, and then pushed the orange in, and then the strawberry came with me into the lava. Okay. So I'm a strawberry, I stick to strawberry. I have one other idea. Well, no, I don't have eyeballs as the other colors. So it ought not be the case that, for example, if I were to push blue onto the button, if I press the button, I can't, like, enter as blue with eyeballs or something. Okay. So what have I failed to account for? My brain tells me this won't help. But if I were to push blue down here, does that mean that I can get across? No, of course not. We still have problems, and the same thing would happen with coconut. And by losing that strawberry, there's now no way for me to solve that one and this one simultaneously. So that is definitely not the solution. So what is the solution? What happens if I go into this puzzle and then press back? It brings me back to exactly the state, and I'm located in exactly the same place. And that's true if I go in this one as well, right? Back, yes. I end up back in this one this time in the exact same place. Okay. So, on the one hand, this is part of the Ouroboros area, which makes me think I want to recurse. And on the other hand, I can't see a reason to want to recurse. But I also don't see a way to solve the puzzle within the constraints that I have going on here, right? I didn't try pushing this all the way down here. If I do that, I can now do this, which seems good. That is now in the correct location, and this is now in the correct location. And this is in the correct location. Perfect. Okay, finally saw it. Okay, that did not give me any insight into this previous puzzle with the deep stack. Bin packing. Let's actually back out. I want to look at it at this level. Okay, so there's a bunch of different slices, and there's a grape that needs to move down, and I have to pull a giant white thing out. Okay. There's all the pieces. And so the problem is, if I try to push this to the left, I succeed, but I can't push it far enough in order to undo because these things don't all fit over here. So why can I not simply shorten the size of the bin? Also, I can't cover this. So yeah, why does something as simple as suppose I did this. Actually, suppose I did. Ooh, yeah. There's a lot of space down here. Why don't I get rid of all of these? Like, if I do say that, could I possibly solve it? There's a lot of space. I'm not sure how much. Something got clogged even sooner. Oh, at the bottom, of course. I can't fill the bottom area. Okay. So, I see. All of this needs to stay clear. Okay, so I want to take this box of white that is to my right. I want to move it over here, but make sure that this, through this, there is some walking path to get from here to here at the end. That doesn't seem too bad. Let's just see how much of that we can do trivially. That seems fine. Then let's see, there's a bunch of large pieces that probably need to be counted out better than I'm currently doing. Let's push that one further to the left. And now I can kind of separate it from the rest. Let's imagine that this needs to go here. And then let's go ahead and peel off the one. And then put this here. Let's try that for the moment. Let's put the one here. And then I've got 4, 4, 3, 2. Well, if I had a 4 here, I don't really have a great spot for all these. Let's just kind of see what happens. So something like that almost kind of looks good, but I'm only going to be able to move things over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tiles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Got it. And so that's not enough. So I needed to somehow, I needed to pack this in even further. Let's imagine that one I could get to an 11th tile, but I need to get to 12. And I don't see how it's possible to get to 12. Oh, I don't need to have all of this as open space. So long as that one is open, I could then push it back out once I step inward. Okay, so now I understand the actual problem, which is I want to pack all of the coconut into this area with just this as a hole and just this as a hole, and then I can burrow my way back out once I recurse. Okay, with a better understanding of that, let's start with the simplest bits. Get a big slice over here. And so now I think I want a 2 up here. There's only 1, 2 in existence. So let's not worry about that bit just yet. I am choosing to do. And instead, let's put this here again. I would want a 3 here. There's only 1, 3 in existence. Alright, before we get to that 3, I think this one looks like it's going to fit right here. Maybe I wanted to do this differently. How much extra space, like, would I have? So if I were to pack this over here, like so, this could just go to the left. This could go here. Yeah, and then there's four squares, and so there's two, and here's the third one, here's the fourth one. So I do have to pack it in totally tightly. Okay, so I need a perfect packing. And so with that newfound understanding, I believe what I've witnessed is this one should actually go here, which means perhaps this one has a mate that would enable it to pack tightly up here. So I would want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I wanted a 5, it just so happens that there is a 5 right here. So let's grab Mr. 5 and push him over here. Great. I eventually want... Oh no, that's not supposed to be a 5. It's supposed to be a 4. Undo. I miscounted. This is a 4. So let's get the 4 and pack it there. Okay, that is perfectly packed. This one could probably be covered. And probably needs to be, I'm thinking. Well, let's not worry about that just yet. I feel like I might be like digging that out once I recurse through the puzzle. So a 3 could go here, yeah. The 1 needs to go way back behind here. Sure. I think this works. And then this guy can go here. Yeah, and then I'm actually going to pack this in against this. Will I be able to get it back out? Oh, I can't, can I? Let's do this anyway and try to figure out the rest of it from there. So this guy can go down, and now I can get all the way into here. I recurse into the puzzle, and now the problem is I cannot unpack the square that I need to get to. So what I'm witnessing is I left a one error hole over here. I actually needed to leave the one error hole directly above the starting position so I'd be able to push over to the right and break this all out. So, with that understanding, let's reset the puzzle once more. And with that understanding, then I think this one wants to go on the bottom, packing tightly. I can't have a 1 here and a 1 here. But I can push to the right as much as I want. So all I need is a space somewhere in this region. So I need a space here, and then I need a space somewhere in this region as the other space. And then the rest of it will work out. Okay, I should be able to finagle that somehow. I think it is safe to put this here because I think there is another 4. That I will want to pair with it. Yes, I see the other 4. Can I extract the other 4 right now? With a small amount of work, so let's do it. So here's the other 4. It can go along the top. I definitely... Things are packed a little tight over here. Let me put these like this for just a moment. That would enable me to get the... Yeah, I can repack these later. Okay. That would enable me to get some of these other guys over here. So I do want the 2 there. I do want a 1 here. I believe... I can fly. I believe that this could go here. No, I'm wasting a space. So that cannot go there. Ooh, and I've got 2 5s and a 3, so I've done something wrong. So the 4s can't go up here. What needs to go here? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need 6, so that has to be a 4 and a 2, or the entire 6. Okay, the 6 needs to go there. So this row needs to be the 1 and the 6. And then I need a 5 and a 3, and a 4 and a 4. Yes, I understand. And the 6 doesn't have to be the bottom, it could also be the top without loss of generality. No, the 1 and the 6 I just said has to be here. Okay, so I need to... That's a little bit more of a pain in the neck to work with, because the 6 is kind of like blocking things. It's Sokoban! Imagine that. 6 is kind of clogging things up pretty badly here from the start, but... That's how we roll. So I said 4 and 4 can go along the top. So there's a 4. And the other 4... I can actually push this over 1, and I'll be able to push it back a little bit later. And so I'm just going to do this so that I can carefully extract some of these guys. I probably did that with more care than was actually needed, but it's fine. So there's a 4 and a 4. A 5 and a 3 could go on the bottom, but I need to get that 1 out before I forget about it. How am I going to get the 1 out? Can I get it out now? Yes. Okay, so with the 1, how am I walking the 1 over here? I can still push this guy down, so it's okay to do this. Not that though. Push the 1 down, push the 1 left, push the 1 up, push the 1 left. Then push this guy back down. So those are their final resting spots. Then a 5 and a 3. Sure. 5 and a 3. You guys can be slotted in over here. Bloop. And then if I put a 2 in here... and leave an airspace, then I'll be able to climb up into there. I'll be able to go right and then up and solve the puzzle. Okay, that was actually really fun. I enjoyed this one. Doop, 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 doop. Perfect. I've done it. All right. Let's take a look at this one. Circular requirement brings me red O to I. And that looks like all I can do right now, so let's do it. If I want to flatten this, it seems like that's going in a general flattening kind of direction. And then if I were to do this, oops, sorry. If I were to do this, it's flattened a little bit further. And then if I were to do this, now it's become the correct shape, and then I can push it into place. Great, solved. So that has given me access to a blue jelly that it looks like eventually I need to push from the other side, but for now let's just go over here and solve this puzzle. Red Z to T. And so I could turn it into a T, but then I wouldn't be able to get it off the wall. So there is another step. Or 3. What do I think said other step is? Honestly, I feel like I might need to start with that. If I did that and this, that's no good. What are the opening moves here? Opening moves, where are you? I'm sure you're hiding in here somewhere. Like, that is pinned against the right wall. That's pinned against the north wall. We already showed this is pinned against the left wall. The only jutty bit is this bit. But I already have that jutty shape. Ah, but I can shear. And that has helped me not a whit, because all I could do is put it back. But I could do that. That doesn't shear. And we already did... Oh, that does actually change it into a different shape, but now it's stuck. Is it stuck? Hold on, it's not stuck. That's the thing. Okay, new shape. Not a stuck shape. Also not a stuck shape. We're making progress once again. We got over the hump. And yeah, we're there, because I can shear this off. There is the final shape I want to make, and here's the leverage I need to get it there. Okay, so that created the coconut. So, both of these puzzles have been solved, but they're in the opposite order. So, if I back out, re-enter this puzzle, they stayed solved. Okay, this maybe gave me the insight that I needed for the other one. This maybe gave me the insight that I needed for the other one. Okay, success. So that is lit up. So, this guy, deep stack. Staying solved. When I re-entered the puzzle. See, but this is still lit up. Yeah. Oh, because I never solved either of them. Right. The problem is I haven't solved either of these puzzles. I haven't been able to get a grape up here, and that's definitely impossible because the grape doesn't even exist. I also have not been able to get a strawberry in here, which seems like it might be possible since I am a strawberry who exists, but I would need to solve this first. And the only way I can solve it is to have solved it, hence the recursive paradox. What am I not thinking of now? And also, is it noteworthy that I can do this? I don't think so. It says 0 of 3 solved. Hold on. 0 of 3 solved. Deep Stack Part 1. Deep Stack Part 2. I do not see a yellow circle anywhere for Part 3. Why is it 0 of 3 solved? This is Ouroboros. If I solve the Ouroboros, is that gonna help me somehow? I don't know, but I'm going to choose to do it in not the most efficient way possible. So if I were to do this, it does light that up. 10 of 14 solved. So there's the outer puzzle, maybe. Or I guess there's this one, like this whole game area I haven't solved. And then inside here, apparently there are three puzzles and I've only located two of them. Okay, well that's something that I think I'll have to think about before next time. I'm going to say that I hope, as always, that you all are having a great day, and I will see you again soon with more Jelly is Sticky. For now, bye-bye.